If you just got the ASUS ROG Ally or you've had it for a while, first, congratulations. Second, grab it so you can follow along with the ultimate tips for charging, your launcher, and other tricks to be able to get the best out of this wonderful device. Hi, I'm Captain Awesome and this is Geekception. I'd really appreciate if you hit that like button and subscribe as it really helps me here. I also have memberships in case you want to stick around as that will go a long way. Number one, recommended command center shortcuts. The command center gives you the options of 15 quick shortcuts. Open Armory Crate with the button on the right, go to settings, press A to customize, and I recommend you enable operating mode to change your power profile, control mode to change your right thumbstick to a mouse when you need it, refresh rate for easy access to be able to change your refresh rate, CPU boost, which I will come to in a while, resolution for easy access to all three resolutions, and real-time monitor. Essential Ally Shortcuts. The ROG Ally has two buttons on the back, M1 and M2. When you press and hold the M2 button, you can use several shortcuts such as M2 plus up D-pad to bring up the keyboard, M2 plus left D-pad to show your Ally desktop, M2 plus right D-pad to show the task switcher, M2 plus down D-pad to show the task manager, M2 plus X for display options, M2 plus A to take a screenshot, M2 plus Y to start a screen recording, and M2 plus B to bring up notifications. Replace Armory Crate with PlayNite. The default launcher installed on the ROG Ally is Armory Crate, and while it is good and gets the basics right, for a truly great experience, you want PlayNite. PlayNite is a launcher that enables you to not only launch your games, but provides different plugins and add-ons to enhance your experience. Joey's Retro Handheld made like a very good PlayNite guide. I'll link it down in the description below. My favorite theme for PlayNite is the Hero theme, and because I had so many questions about it, let me show you how to set it up. After installing the Hero theme in the settings, make sure you first enter full screen mode. Go to Settings, Visuals, then select Hero Theme. It will ask to restart. Select Yes, and that's how you enable the theme. I also have a couple of my favorite PlayNite plugins, and in case you want to see all of that, I made a video about what's on my ASUS ROG Ally video linked down there below. View your Ally performance. Want to see how well your Ally is running in games? Click the Command Center button, enable real-time monitor, and you can see how well your Ally is performing while you game, with several display options depending on your taste. And if you need to adjust your settings for better performance, get best ROG Ally game settings. Head to rogally.games to see user shared settings for the Ally. You can search for your favorite games and see the settings that other users have shared also. I like that it even has settings for emulated games as well. Get free games for your Ally. If you don't already, sign up for an Epic Games account, install the launcher, and keep an eye out for free games, which they give out almost constantly. It's how I've been able to get all of these games, including GTA 5 and other notable games, for free. Best charger for your Ally. Now, the Ally comes with this 65-watt charger, but did you know that you can use other chargers as well? But Captain Awesome, turbo mode is not going to work if I use other chargers, right? Wrong! But this is not the full truth. While yes, it is always recommended to use the original charger that comes with your device, any charger that is greater than 30 watts actually works pretty well too. Yes, in the performance mode, it will only show you 25 watts, but you're actually getting full 30 watts, and here is how we can test it. So using a non-ROG Ally charger, and we load a game, turn on the real-time monitor, and you can see that the game is actually using up to 30 watts. So I think it's just a bug in the UI interface, or maybe it's just ASUS's way of scaring you into getting the official chargers, but other chargers will totally work fine. Get the best Ally performance. If you want to get the best performance out of your ROG Ally, I recommend you use it plugged in. And yes, I know it's a handheld, you want to use it handheld, but there is no denying that the moment you plug this device into the power outlet, you get so much more better performance out of it. And you know, isn't that what you want? Don't you want to play all your games? Well, I would say plug it in and get all that good boost. Get the best battery life by disabling CPU boost. If you play handheld, then this is for you, because several Ally users have found that disabling CPU boost actually increases battery life. And before, you had to do like this weird registry tricks to be able to get a CPU boost disabled, but now right in the command center right there, you can actually just enable a widget that gives you quick access to it. If you want to take it a step further, I have linked a video by Chris about how to get the maximum battery life out of the ROG Ally. Check it out, link in the description down there. How to quit unresponsive apps and games. If your current app or game freezes or becomes unresponsive, it's actually very easy to quit it. Press the command center button, click end task, tap on close, and the app should exit. Use your Ally in desktop mode. If you want to surf websites, do file management, or just use your Ally as a desktop PC, then you'll need desktop mode. Open your command center, tap on control mode till you see desktop mode, and you can now use your Ally as a desktop with the right thumbsticks acting as a mouse. To use a left mouse stick, press in on the right thumbstick until you hear a click. For a right click, tap and hold on the screen and the context menu should pop up. Don't upgrade your ROG Ally storage. Now listen, I'm a maximalist, okay? I love to take up a lot of space. I love to install my entire library if I could. So this advice feels a little bit counterintuitive, but I would say in the rush to download all our games from Steam, from Epic, from, you know, Game Pass and everywhere, it actually becomes less about just, you know, using your Ally to play the games that you enjoy and becomes more of how many games can I put on this? And eventually maybe we lose sight of the fact that, you know, just play a few games, right? And I think having that 521 gigs limitation here on the ROG Ally has really forced me to only keep games that I know that I'm going to play, as opposed to, you know, buying a 2 terabyte SSD, installing like 50 games there and not even playing one in like 6 months. So I would say, like, yes, it might be, you know, a bit opposite of what I would normally suggest, but I would say keep the 512 gigs, play the games that you have there. When you're done with it, you know, delete it, install the next game. And, you know, after 6 months, you tell me how many games you've played. And if you're someone who has, you know, installed a 2 terabyte drive or 1 terabyte drive, I want to know your thoughts about, you know, did it actually make you play more games or are you playing less games? Let me know in the comments down there below. Update your Ally frequently. ASUS has been very generous with updates to the ROG Ally here. And you can get updates specifically from 4 locations: the Microsoft Store, my ASUS app, Armory Crate, and Windows Update. Updating your Ally makes sure that you get better performance in games, with sometimes new features introduced such as Gyro that ASUS gave in an update last year. Play desktop games on your Ally. Do you already have a gaming PC and just want to stream your games to the Ally? Then Moonlight is for you. I've left a link to a quick guide below on how to set up Moonlight and play your desktop games on your Ally in case you just want to use it as a handheld, you know, screen for your desktop gaming PC. Cloud gaming to the rescue. Are you running out of space on your Ally, or you just want to get the best performance and also the best battery life? Then cloud gaming might be for you. Now, while you can play almost any desktop game on your Ally right here, cloud gaming allows you to be able to play games at even higher resolutions with more powerful computers that are just streaming it to your Ally. And you can get the best of both worlds, which is portability thanks to the Ally, it is handheld, and game performance thanks to this very powerful computer that you do not have to worry about, you know, TDP and power or whatever. And yes, cloud gaming is not free, or at least for me in my market, it's not free. But depending on wherever you are, maybe due to limitations on your Ally or battery life or whatever, that might be something worth considering for your Ally. Rewatch your best moments. Now, I don't know about you, but I tend to record or take screenshots of some of the games that I'm playing, but you might be wondering where to find it. Wonder no more, because let's go to File Explorer first, then click on Videos on the left, then Captures, and all your recorded content will be here. For easy access, I recommend you pin it to your favorites by dragging the folder to the tab on the left. The ROG Ally subreddit. Now, I recommend visiting the ROG Ally subreddit for tips, tricks, and just about, you know, people sharing their experiences with the Ally. This is really helpful, especially if you want to be able to get real life, you know, experience of people using the Ally. And sometimes even when games are crashing, people on Reddit have already figured out what to do and what to change and what to download. So I'd really recommend, even if you're not an active Reddit member, just, you know, visiting there occasionally. ROG Ally Life. Now, this is the best source of news and updates that I've found personally for the ROG Ally. They have news about new updates, mods, accessories, and even game settings. And what I like is that you get a detailed settings guide for not just about the game, but of the Ally as well. I also recommend you follow their Twitter account so you can see all of the latest updates that they have. Best way to put your Ally to sleep. Now, you finish gaming and you want to put your Ally to sleep. So you press the power button, right? Wrong, because when your Ally is asleep, it's actually very easy for the system to wake it up. This can be due to software updates, we all know of Windows, or even accidental button presses in your bag or something. And trust me, you do not want to cook your Ally by, you know, it turning on in your bag and now suddenly it's been on for like 30 minutes, draining your battery, the fans are going on full blast, and we do not want that. Instead, what I recommend is opening up the command center, tap on the power icon, then select hibernate. This will save the state of the Ally before shutting down. And when you press the power button again, it will actually resume to wherever it is that you stopped. And people have mixed opinions about hibernate mode, but for me, I would say that this has been the best solution that I've found to be able to put my Ally to sleep. Play more games. And while all of this is fun, being able to optimize your Ally, being able to get your case, your accessories, your news, your updates, and all of this wonderful stuff, nothing beats just, you know, opening up your Ally right here, launching your favorite games and just playing, you know, disappearing into the worlds of the games that have been crafted to capture your attention and capture your soul. And, you know, where, you know, at the end of the day, like I remember being a kid lying down on my bed, like at 13 years old, and imagining one day where I'll be able to play games on my hands, and not just like a Game Boy thing in 8-bit or whatever, but like full games with 3D worlds. And look at us, look at where we are. Who would have thought, right? So I would say, yes, you know, you might go down this, you know, a rabbit hole of optimizing this or downloading that or installing this, but nothing beats just grabbing your Ally, playing a game that you like, and just having fun. And on that note, I will be saying thank you so much for watching this video. It's been in the works for a while, but I've been wanting to bring out this video since I made my What's on My ROG Ally video. Hope you are having fun with your Ally. Please, since you've made it all the way to the end, tell me some of the games you're playing on your ROG Ally. Maybe I'll check out some of them. Tell me some of your tips or some of your tricks that you've learned, and I'll definitely want to check them out if I missed some of them. Or if you want me to make other videos such as like a PlayNite customization guide or anything, I would be more than happy to, you know, explore some of those options. But yes, enough of all of this. Go play games. I want to play games as well. And I've been your captain of awesome. This is Geekception. Don't forget to like and subscribe, as that really helps me here on this channel. Donate, you know, pay a PayPal memberships here, my Ko-fi page, if what I've the tips I've given you here actually helped you. Until then, I've been your captain of awesome, like I said, and I'll see you in the next one. Don't forget to stay awesome. Bye.